It seems to me that people are helped considerably to understand an author when they know something of his life. This knowledge will explain his attitude to certain matters which otherwise would not be quite understood. But authors like myself, who for a number of years have led a wild and unprofitable life, must be careful of what they say. Before I read my poem, Leisure, I would like to explain that any listener who gets the impression that they were written by a lazy man will be entirely mistaken. The fact that I am the author of over 50 books will prove that I have really been something of a slave. Now, why did I work like a slave? For this simple reason, I choose my own tasks and then found joy in doing them. So that it seems to me that the finest life on earth is to choose the work you love, and it must then follow that the harder you work, the happier you will be. Some people will contend that if we had this real freedom to choose our own tasks, every man would want to fill some high office, and no one would be left to do the dirty work. But this is not right, for each man would choose according to his temperament. No doubt we would have a lot of trouble over so many applicants for the office of Prime Minister or Chancellor of the Exchequer. It would only be fair and just to warn these mentally deficient applicants that Prime Ministers are betrayed, abused and blamed for everything and are always full of care and worry. And that at certain periods, the Chancellor of the Exchequer is the most unpopular man in the state. And if these poor, demented applicants, having been told these things, still insisted, well, we would be compelled to put them away. This is the first poem, Leisure. What is this life if full of care, we have no time to stand and stare? No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. No time to see when woods we pass, where squirrels hide their nuts in grass. No time to see in broad daylight, streams full of stars like skies at night. No time to turn at beauty's glance and watch her feet how they can dance. No time to wait till her mouth can enrich that smile her eyes began. A poor life this is full of care, we have no time to stand and stare.